Business Central Telemetry. Analyze performance using a Power BI report. Business Central emits telemetry data for various activities and operations on tenants and extensions. Monitoring telemetry gives you insight into activities and the health of your tenants, so you can diagnose problems and analyze operations that affect performance. This video shows how to use a standard Power BI report to analyze performance with telemetry. The report is available from the Business Central Telemetry Samples GitHub repository. We'll download the report, get an application ID from Azure Application Insights, then we'll explore the performance report in Power BI Desktop. Prerequisites for using the report is to have enabled telemetry on one or more Business Central environments or extensions, and access to the Azure Applications Insight resource that stores the data. We'll also need Power BI Desktop. Let's start by downloading the reports. We'll open a browser and type aka.ms/bctelemetrysamples to open the BC Tech repository. Now we'll choose the Power BI directory, then Reports, and then Performance Report. To download the report, we'll choose Download. We'll open the report to start configuring it. We need an application ID from the Azure Application Insights resource that stores the telemetry data. We need the key so that we can read data from Azure Application Insights. On the Application Insights page in the Azure portal, under Configure on the navigation pane, we'll choose API Access and then use the Copy to Clipboard action to copy the application ID. Now we'll open the Performance Report Power BI file we downloaded. We'll paste the Application Azure Insights application ID in the App ID field, and then define the period of time we want to analyze by specifying start and end dates. We can also add an AAD tenant ID and an environment name as additional filters. Especially for extension telemetry, sometimes it's useful to leave these fields blank if we have enabled Azure Application Insights for multiple environments. If we have a lot of data and just want to experiment, we might consider using the top parameter to limit the number of rows that each data source in the report will fetch from Azure Application Insights. When we choose Load, the report will refresh with data. This can take a few minutes depending on the amount of data we have. Authentication from Power BI to Application Insights only works if both resources belong to the same AAD tenant ID, the organizational account. Okay, here's our report. Let's start with the README tab. There are two things that are especially important to notice. First, there's guidance on the difference between the Power BI report and the Jupyter notebooks for troubleshooting. The performance report is useful when we don't know exactly what we're looking for and need to slice and dice the data to find performance bottlenecks. Second, depending on our version of Business Central, we might not have data for every tab in the report. There's a link to the Signal Overview page where we can find out when different types of signals were added to Business Central. Now let's dive into the performance data. The Sessions and Open Company tabs give us an overview of session creation count and performance. We can identify the type of client that opens a session by filtering on client type. A typical cause of performance issues is frequent calls to web service endpoints on the Business Central environment. For example, if we have thousands of calls per day on the Sessions tab, we might want to reduce our web service calls. While the Sessions tab shows the count of sessions being created, the Open Company tab shows how well the code running in the On Open Company trigger is performing. This code runs every time a session is created and should normally complete in less than a few seconds. If the graph shows spikes of 10 seconds or more, we should probably investigate whether extensions are running slow AL code in the trigger and try to remove the bottleneck. The long-running SQL queries tab helps us investigate AL code that results in operations that take a long time to run on the database. We can go from an AL call stack to see which SQL statements took a long time to run, as well as information about the number of joins in the SQL statements and how many SIFT indexes. We can also sort on expensive SQL statements to identify AL code that can be optimized. The former search pattern is great if we already know that a particular page is slow, while the latter is useful if we're looking for the top 10 performance bottlenecks in the Business Central database. Database locks are often a root cause of performance problems. While long-running SQL queries measure how long it takes the queries to run in the database, Database lock timeouts identify situations where a user waited too long for a lock to be released and was shown an error that indicates that a record in the table was locked by another user. Like the long-running SQL Queries tab, we can go from the AL call stack to the SQL statement, or go from the SQL statement to see the AL call stack. The next tab we'll explore is long-running AL methods. Here we get statistics on time spent running AL inside the Business Central server, excluding time spent in the database. Two good ways to use this part of the report are either to choose in objects to see the slow methods, or to filter or sort on methods to find the top 10 slowest. When we identify a slow method, we can go directly to the telemetry to get the AL call stack to find out where the method is run in the code. We talked about web service calls when we explored the Sessions tab. On the Incoming Web Service Calls tab, we can go deeper into web service endpoint performance. We can go from an endpoint to the code unit behind it, or from a code unit to the endpoints that use it. An important part of this report is the category filter, where we can see which protocols are used. We should try to use API pages and move away from OData version 3 and SOAP. Outgoing web service calls are tracked in telemetry when we use the HTTP client module in AL to call external services. Especially for UI sessions, it's important to check the performance of these external calls because running AL is blocked in the server while it waits for an answer from an external service. The Reports tab shows the performance of reports. For each report, we can see how many times it was run, the number of SQL statements, and how many rows were fetched. The ratio of these numbers can tell us how set-based the code behind the report is. We can use the client type filter at the top of the report to determine whether users are running reports from the request page or scheduling them. Using the request page forces users to wait for the result, so scheduling might improve perceived performance. Finally, the Page Views tab shows the time it takes to render pages in the modern client. You can use this to identify the top 10 pages to improve. You can also use filters to analyze whether people are using old browser versions that have known performance issues. And that's it! To learn more about Power BI reports based on telemetry and Azure Application Insights, visit aka.ms/BC telemetry samples. You'll find links to sample reports and additional information about how to connect Power BI to telemetry in Azure Application Insights. If you're interested in learning more about Business Central and telemetry, there are a few additional videos available on this playlist. There's one that shows how to get started with Application Insights, one that shows how to triage errors using a standard Power BI report, one about writing your own queries in Kusto, and one about troubleshooting using Jupyter Notebook Guides. Thanks for watching.